Analytics, we've conducted the world's first benchmarking of Microsoft Teams. We've benchmarked 15 organisations worldwide, more than 5,300 teams, and over a million Teams interactions. Laurie, you're Swoop Analytics Chief Scientist. Can you tell me some of the key points you've found from benchmarking so many interactions?
Interactions and Teams, yeah. Well, 5,300 Teams is a lot of Teams in anyone's language. And as you expect, Teams is a new platform, so people are still experimenting quite a lot. So nearly over 60%, in fact, you would say are experimental teams. People are just starting, seeing what the functions are and so forth. But we still did have close to 40% of the teams that were doing quite useful stuff, right? So the way I look at the platform is that, you know, there's like three different lands inside Teams, right? So we've got our Teams channels and so forth, which is where we expect the teams to be. But you know, the most active area is actually the chat area, and chats can evolve into calls as well. So you know, it's a very rich interaction area as well. And of course, we've got our online meetings and so forth, which is the smallest area. Now you can imagine having these three lands where you've got people coming in from using other tools, if you like, to start to occupy the team space. And we're starting to talk about it a lot as like, it looks like the Ellis Island, the digital Ellis Island, where people are coming either from Skype or from SharePoint or from Yammer or from Outlook and Mail. And they're all assembling here, you know, looking for the new world, if you like. But in fact, at the moment, they're just trying on their, you know, their new clothes and saying, well, what can we do in chat now rather than doing it in email or in Skype or what have you? So
sticking with what they know, but then dipping their toes in.
So I think that's a natural thing to do, to say, well, you know, how does this work in this new tool and seeing, and they've got extra functionality and so forth. But I think the other thing we found was that, you know, when we talk about Teams, and that's the name of the product, obviously, when we think about our teams at work, the people that we work with every day, usually you might have a team of 4, 5, 6 people. You wouldn't think that you'd have a team with, say, 20 or 30 people. But in fact, that's exactly the case. In fact, our biggest team had over 3,000 people in the team. So that's clearly not what we would say was a traditional team. So what we're discovering is that there's quite a number of different team types. And within Swoop, we're able to characterize that because we profile teams in the same way as Facebook might profile your buying behavior, Sharon. We profile how teams' interaction behavior is. And we've found that there's, other than the inactive ones I've talked about, there's four different types of teams, of which, you know, only a proportion are actually what we would call a traditional team. And so I guess the other big thing we're finding is that looking at all of the data, you know, sort of, with all of our measures, so we've got many, many measures, and they're all based on our social network analytics sort of principles, you know, there is a big gap between the best practice and the average practice, right? So, and that's good in a way, because that's the opportunity gap. So we know what we can look up to. We know what good looks like in terms of how people are actually interacting, not what they're saying they're doing, but what they're actually doing. And we can use that as a practice to learn from. So we see that this big opportunity gap is something that organisations can use to accelerate the way they become productive with teams.
Okay, well, thank you for sharing that, Laurie. We'll touch more on that, those best practices, in another video.
Wonderful, thank you.
Thank you.